بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case scenario today. This is X-ray obtained from newborn baby. Born by difficult vaginal delivery. But in your mind, difficult vaginal delivery. This is the clue of the quiz. The birth weight is 4.6 kg. Another clue for this quiz. The weight of the baby 4.6. Actual large gestational age babies, it will be more than 4 kg or more than 90 centile. The true statement regarding the etiology of his condition is, so you have two clues. First clue, this is difficult vaginal delivery. The second one, the weight of the baby is 4.6, is large gestational age baby. So what is the true statement about the etiology of this condition? You can concentrate, he brought for you what? This is the X-ray. You see, this is X-ray, he brought it for you. As we know, this is baby, it will be infant of diabetic mother and birth trauma. Because difficult delivery, large baby, it will be difficult deliveries lead to birth trauma. Birth trauma, the most common birth trauma, it will be fractures. As we know, the fracture, it will be in the clavicle. But since he give you the limb, all the limb, you have to concentrate and focus for the humerus. Because this is the most common also. Complication of the birth trauma, fracture humerus. You see here, the humerus is fractured. You see here, supposed to be, will mislead you to the clavicle. You are going to look for the clavicle. But the clavicle, it's okay. You see here, because difficult labor and large baby, you have to concentrate also, and you have to look for the humerus. Don't look for the clavicle, please. If you have large baby, difficult labor, don't concentrate for the clavicle alone. You have to concentrate also, you have to look for the humerus. Because also, this is one of the most common birth injuries. It's happening for infant diabetic mother. It will be fracture humerus. Humerus, it, because it will be difficult labor. If is there another limb, if you also have to concentrate for the old limb also for any fracture. But here, in our case here, the fracture was in the humerus. So this baby, we'll see the true statement. A, maternal obesity, no. Is maternal hypocalcemia, no. Maternal hyperglycemia, no. Maternal hyperglycemia, yes. Maternal hyperglycemia. And the last E, it's maternal hyperparathyroidism. So this patient is infant of diabetic mother, large baby, because that is the labor, it was difficult. And the complication of the difficult vaginal delivery with large baby, it will lead to fracture. Either fracture clavicle or fracture humerus, sometimes herpes palsy. So if you go for the case discussion, the preferred response, it will be D. And what our objectives from this quiz or this case, our objectives from this case, to know the complication of macrosomia and difficult labor. This is the clue, to know the complication of macrosomia and difficult labor. And our critical assessment, difficult delivery, this is the most common cause of humerus fracture. Put it in your mind. Don't look for the clavicle alone if large baby or difficult labor. Please, it will mislead you. Look for the humerus also. Look for the humerus also. IDM are macrosomic and are prone for this. Our case study, from where the reference? It's come from Fanarov and Martin. So, as we know, the infant with diabetic mother, if you go for upstairs for the algorithm, this is maternal hyperglycemia. For sure, it led to fetal hyperglycemia. Again, it will lead to fetal hyperinsulinemia. Hyperglycemia, the pancreas will start to secrete insulin. It's led to hyperinsulinemia. Hyperinsulinemia, as we know, the insulin is anabolic hormone. Anabolic hormone. What will happen? The fetal substrate uptake will increase. Fetal substrate, it will increase. What will happen? It's the fat will lead to adipose tissues will increase, and the fat deposition will increase. The baby will be macrosomic and large baby. It can be more than 4 kilograms or more than 90 centile. So because what? Because the insulin is anabolic. Anabolic, what is the meaning of anabolic? It's lead to substrate uptake, increase adipose tissues in the increase adipose tissues and deposition of the fat in different areas, especially in the cheeks. So the baby, it will be moon face or cushingoid face or something like that. So it will lead to macrosomia. So هايبر انسولينيميا ات ليد تو انكريز ذا فيتال سبستريت ابتيك ليد تو ماكروسوميا. وات ايلس It, what else will happen for the oxygenation and ventilation? If you will go for the oxygenation, what will happen? Oxygen uptake also will increase. The demand will increase. So it's lead to hypoxemia. Hypoxemia, it lead to prenatal asphyxia and stillbirth or increase erythropoietin. Erythropoietin if increase, the hemoglobin mass will increase. The baby will be polycythemia. Polycythemia, it lead to hyperbilirubinemia. It lead to renal vein thrombosis and all of this. So the other area it will be affected here, the ventilation, the lung surfactant, it will decrease. As we know, the insulin and testosterone, the insulin actually, it will inactivate the surfactant. As we know, the IDM baby, it will be full term. So the surfactant is there. But for IDM babies, it's not matter of surfactant senses. It's matter of surfactant function defect. The surfactant is there, but the function is affected and defect in the function. And this is the difference between the RDS, it's due to surfactant senses deficiency, and for fault in the IDM baby, the surfactant is there, but the function is affected. So the infant with IDM baby, it will also having respiratory distress, and this respiratory distress, for sure, it's due to actually surfactant function defect and lead to RDS syndrome. So the IDM baby have RDS syndrome, but it's not due to surfactant senses defect. It's due to surfactant function defect. So the neonatal or maternal hyperglycemia lead to fetal hyperglycemia, lead to fetal hyperinsulinemia. Fetal hyperinsulinemia, it's lead to what? Lead to oxygenation defect and ventilation defect, and increase its anabolic hormone. It's lead to increase the fetal substrate uptake, so it lead to macrosomia. So the complication, fetal and neonatal complication of the hyperinsulinemia, it's lead to, you see here, it's macrosomia due to increased anabolic effect of the insulin and the substrate uptake. Hypoglycemia, for sure, insulin is high, it lead to hypoglycemia. Polycythemia, because he will increase the erythropoietin, and hypoxia lead to erythropoietin will increase, lead to polycythemia. Polycythemia lead to hyperbilirubinemia, and for sure, it will, because hemoglobin mass is high, it can lead to renal vein thrombosis, cardiomyopathy, and RDS due to what? Because the insulin, it will affect the surfactant function and lead to RDS. Here, this is the birth injuries. It's due to macrosomia. You see here, I'm concentrating for, you see here, this is the humerus. You see, humerus rupture. Sorry, fracture. You see, humerus fracture. Don't concentrate for the clavicle only. You have to consider it also the humerus. Another injuries, it lead to herpes palsy. If it's fractured not happening, can be the nerve, it will be affected. It lead to herpes palsy. Also, it lead to kefal hematoma. If you see here, it's a kefal hematoma. It can lead to kefal hematoma. Large bit lead to kefal hematoma. Also, if you see here, this is polycythemia. The baby is blutheric phase. Blutheric phase. Another macrosomia complications, this is a complication associated with the delivery. The birth trauma, it lead to shoulder dystocia. Brachial plexus injury, fracture clavicle. You see fracture clavicle, but don't forget the fracture humerus. Also, it will come in the actually in the exam all the time to mislead you. All the time you are look for the clavicle, because commonly it will be the clavicle, but also you put in your mind with difficulty of a large baby, you have to look for the humerus also. This is our aim and objective from this quiz, to look all the time to the clavicle, then look for the humerus. Fracture also visceral can lead to visceral hemorrhage, can lead to birth asphyxia, good oxygenation defect, a risk associated with cesarean section and operative vaginal delivery and vacuum also extraction and for sips. Moon face, the classic face of the infant of diabetic mother, it will be Cushingoid face, or we call it moon face, because the position of the adipose tissues in the cheeks. You see here, the baby looks dull shape or moon shape. You see, the birth weight, it will be the what is the definition of large gestational age? The weight, it will be more than 4 kg or more than 90 centile or percentile for gestational age. It occur also the macrosomia, it will be 20 to 60% of the cases of the infant of the diabetic mother. Physical finding, you see, increased adipose tissue. Why this baby is macrosomic? Because the insulin is anabolic and increase the substrate uptake and increase the adipose tissue, especially in the cheeks actually, and it will be disproportion of the head and shoulder ratio. Also the baby will be polyuric because the polycythemia and because the erythropoietin is high and because the hypoxia, large placenta and cord. This is one of the differential diagnosis of large placenta. What is the differential diagnosis of large placenta? Hydropic placenta, nephrotic placenta and diabetic placenta. This is the pathophysiology. If you see here, the pathophysiology of the hyperglycemia, maternal diabetes, what will happen? Lead to fetal hyperinsulinemia, maternal hyperglycemia, lead to neonatal hypoglycemia, and jitterness. If you see here, maternal diabetes, maternal diabetes, it lead to the increased abortion and the stillbirth. If the pregnancy is continue, might the baby have, it will be premature or might lead to fetal abnormalities. If also if the long term diabetes and not controlled, lead to renovascular disease, and this is actually it will be impaired of fetal growth, small gestational age. So the diabetic mother can deliver baby with a small gestational age, because all in our mind, diabetic mother, the baby will be big baby. It can be a small baby, but when it will be a small gestational age baby, if the diabetes long term and not controlled, and the mother started to having more complication from diabetes, like what? Like cardiac or renovascular disease. Once the mother having renal vascular disease, cardiac disease, it lead to impair of the fetal growth, and the baby will be small, not large as we usual we see in the diabetic mother. So fetal hyperinsulinemia and maternal hyperglycemia, what will happen for the pancreas? It will beta cell hyperplasia, it lead to macrosomia, baby it will be large gestational age. You see, it was a small gestational age of the mother having renal vascular disease and long term diabetes, and the baby having large gestational age is associated with hyperinsulinemia, because the insulin is anabolic and increased substrate uptake, and also it lead to cardiac hypertrophy, asymmetrical septal hypertrophy. This is acyanotic heart disease associated with diabetic mother, asymmetrical septal hypertrophy. And also for sure it lead to, if the baby big due to hyperinsulinemia, it's lead to birth trauma, fracture clavicle, fracture humerus. If the bone is not fractured, maybe the nerve, it will be injury, it will brachial plexus injury, brachial plexus injury. If you go to other side here, other side here, you see here, this is hyperinsulinemia. What will happen? It will decrease the parathyroid maturation. It will lead to hypocalcemia and hypomagnesemia. So, if anyone will ask you during the oral exam, what is the cause or why the infant of diabetic mother having hypocalcemia and hypomagnesemia? It's due to hyperinsulinemia. It lead to decreased parathyroid maturation. Also, why the infant of diabetic mother having RDS? Due to the insulin, actually, it will affect the surfactant function and lead to decreased lung maturation. Also, it will increase the fetal metabolism. It lead to relatively hypoxemia. Hypoxemia, it lead to perinatal asphyxia. It lead to polycythemia. And polycythemia lead to hyperbilirubinemia. It's okay. So this is the small infant of diabetic mother also having a small gestational age baby. When this is happen, if in advanced diabetes complicated with renal and cardiac disease. So is macrosomic baby and the small gestational babies is all associated with diabetes. But when the small gestational age happen with diabetes or maternal diabetes, if the mother late diabetes and ده uncontrolled diabetes and long standing diabetes and started the complication with the mother like the renal and cardiac disease. So the we expected or anticipated the baby it will be small, not will be large as we usual we think about it. So this is effect of poor glycemic control in pregnant diabetic woman. Maternal, if you see here, depend on the gestational, depend on the trimester. First trimester, second trimester. In the first trimester during fetal, this is the time of fetal organogenesis. So the all abnormalities and major birth defect, it will happen during the first trimester if the mother not control the diabetes. And our advice to the obstetricians, please preconceptional control the diabetes. From our side, we'll anticipate the complication and treat this complication. So if the maternal hyperglycemia during the first trimester, what is the complication? It will affect the fetal organogenesis and major birth defect will happen and even may happen the spontaneous abortion. طب maternal hyperglycemia it's happen in the second trimester or uncontrolled in the second trimester, it what will happen? It lead to hyperinsulinemia and macrosomia. So this is the infant of diabetic mother, early pregnancy, it's lead to diabetic embryopathy. Diabetic embryopathy. Hyperglycemic embryo, it lead to risk of congenital malformation. All the anomalies, it's due to hyperglycemia. The macrosomia, it's due to hyperinsulinemia. So all the major complication, organogenesis, it all what will happen in the first trimester, uncontrolled diabetes, during the fetal formations, or during the embryogenesis. So it's led to diabetic embryogenesis. So our advice to control diabetes preconceptional, not even that are in the first trimester. This risk, as we know, you have to monitor the mother with hemoglobin A1C. What is the normal hemoglobin in A1C? It will be 6.7. Remember this one, 6 and 7. 6.7, or as we know, this is Naxa 67, 6.7 normal level. Malformation rate of the level, so if the hemoglobin A1C is 6.9 or less, this is what? It will be zero. It will be zero birth defect. If the hemoglobin A1C is 7 to 8.5, what is the percentage of the malformation or what will happen for the birth defect? It will be 5.1%. If the hemoglobin hemoglobin A1C it's 8.6 or greater, the risk of the malformation it will be 22.4%. So there is correlation between the malformation and birth defect with hemoglobin A1C. Hemoglobin A1C the normal 6.7. If any reading less than 6.7 or 6.9, zero organogenesis defect. If 7 to 8 0.5, it will be 5%. If 6.6, 8.6 or greater, it will be higher, 22%. Congenital anomalies of diabetic embryopathy, it will be associated with CNS anomalies, cardiac anomalies, renal anomalies, urinary anomalies, GI tract anomalies, and skeletal anomalies. CNS anomalies associated with diabetes, as we know, neural tube defect. Anencephaly, meningocele, hydrocephalus, holoprosencephaly, you see, all this will be associated neural tube defect. Put in your mind, neural tube defect, sometimes anencephaly or meningocele. You see here, this is the meningocele here, this is meningocele, or the baby it will be hydrocephalus or holoprosencephaly. Another diabetic embryopathy because uncontrolled hyperglycemia with the mother in the preconception or in the first trimester is led to midline defect, facial macrosomia, and also macrotia and anotia. It will be all associated with ear anomalies. Ear anomalies also one of the association with the diabetic mother. Diabetic mother, it will be associated with diabetic embryopathy or midline facial defect. It will be 10.3%. If the mother is controlled the diabetes or glycemic control, actually it will be 1.4%. Here also cardiac abnormalities. This is common question in the Arab board and Saudi board and all of this exam. What is the most common complication, cardiac complication associated with infant of diabetic mother? Acyanotic heart disease, it will be asymmetrical septal hypertrophy. If cyanotic heart disease, it will be TGA, transposition of great vessels. It's called DTGA. Dextro transposition of great vessels. D, put it in your mind, this is diabetes. So diabetes is common cyanotic heart disease associated with infant of diabetic mother, DTGA. These mean dextrocardia. This means the two vessels, it's opposite to each other. As we know, the TGA, it will be the pulmonary in front and the aorta in it's behind to the pulmonary. In the TGA, the pulmonary will actually the aorta it will come in front and the pulmonary will come behind it. So it's transposition, dextroposition of the great vessels. Levo, this means the chamber actually disposition. The chamber, the ventricles, it will be also disposition. If levo, it's so two types. D, dextro, because the vessels, it will be transpositions. And if the chamber transposition, we'll call it levo. Levo, actually, this is the chamber, it will be, actually, it will transposition also. It can also happen coarctation, atrial, ACD, VCD, dextrocardia, single ventricle, hypoplastic ventricle, or BDA. Everything can happen, but what is the most common? It's important for you. Asymmetric heart disease associated with infant of diabetic mother, asymmetrical septal hypertrophy, or hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Or if this cyanotic heart disease, it will be dextro TGA. Dextro, this means the disposition or transposition of great vessels. As we know, this is in the normal, it will be the pulmonary in front and the aorta, it will be behind it. In TGA, it will be the opposite will happen. The aorta will come in front and the pulmonary will be behind. This is called dextro, D. And put in your mind, D, it means diabetes. And this is the cyanotic heart disease associated with the diabetes. And the other, it can levo. Levo, this means the chamber from down, it can transpositions. So GI anomalies associated with infant diabetic mother, for sure, small left colon syndrome. It can happen. You see here, it's small. You see the colon is very small. You see very small, very small. It's actually called small left colon syndrome, and also bowel atresia can happen, and bowel dysmotility and feeding intolerance. Skeletal abnormalities also is common. Caudal regression syndrome or caudal dysplasia. And what is caudal regression? The people before was thinking about sacral agenesis. It's not matter of sacral agenesis nowadays. A sacral agenesis with hypoplastic pelvis is actually nowadays the people thinking broad, not narrow. It's not sacral agenesis, it's called caudal regression syndrome, caudal dysplasia syndrome. So this is rare for sure, and it's almost 1 in 25,000, and most specific malformation related to diabetes, it can happen 200 to 400 times more often in infant diabetic mother. And you see here, this is sacral agenesis with hypoplastic pelvis. And usually other malformation like femoral hypoplasia, extrophy of the blood, and the club foot. This is the sacral agenesis. If you see here, look for the sacral here. It's L1, L2, and you look for the sacral. I cannot see the sacral here. So this is sacral agenesis. If you cannot detect it by the X-ray, you can look for the baby clinically. You see the baby clinically, it will give you, if you see this picture, put in your mind, this is caudal regression syndrome. It's hyperextended leg. You see, you think this is dislocation of the knee or dislocation in the lower limb. No, this put in your mind, it can be the dislocation of the knee joint, but also put in your mind, it will be caudal regression syndrome. What is caudal regression syndrome? This is sacral agenesis with hypoplastic of the pelvis. And there is lecture about this caudal regression syndrome. We'll talk about what is caudal regression and what is how to treat it and all of this in other lecture, inshallah. So at the end, ask Allah العظيم أن ينجح زملائنا لدخلين الفيلوشيب إن شاء الله الأسبوع ده يوم الاثنين الجاي إن شاء الله, ونسأل النجاح لكل زملائنا اللي في الفيلوشيب إن شاء الله, وعلى الأخص الدكتورة أسماء إن شاء الله بالنجاح والتوفيق يا رب إن شاء الله. سلام عليكم.